welcome back. Yep. And as was mentioned earlier in the show, our first segment for today is letting you know all the essentials that you need when you head into the beverage division at Carl H. Menzies to know exactly what to look for your New Year's Eve party or celebration. We're joined by Mala Vasquez and Michael Fuller of the beverage division of Carl H. Menzies. Yes. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning, guys.
Good morning. You know,
it's always nice to have smoothness on a Thursday morning, and this one is going to be good. I've been at the beverage division there at College Menzies, and trust me, it's definitely one of my favorite spots to visit. I love that area. It actually feels nice. It feels classy, but at the same time, trust me, it's a wonderful feel being inside there. New Year's is coming up.
Yes, definitely. Mm-hmm. As you can see, we have a wide selection of beverages today, from our champagnes to our wines to spirits.
It seems that you guys have lined up everything just the way it should be. And I say it from the fact that I don't really know. But at the same time, having the colors mix and match. And then again, seriously, having the colors mix and match. And from class A to class Z, tell us about some of the products that you've got here.
Okay. Perfect.
Can I go first?
Yeah,
yes.
Go ahead.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, for one, good morning, everybody. Mm-hmm. Good morning, Marlene.
And
good
John.
Morning, John. Mm-hmm. Bringing some sparkle into your day.
Yay!
Love
so
sparkles.
What I better way to have sparkles with champagne?
Mm-hmm.
So we have the Armand de Brignac, which is the number one champagne actually in the world. The Armand Gold on that side. First one actually won the number one champagne of the year of 2016. Mm-hmm. It is owned by the Cartier family. And that is handcrafted. The bottles are handcrafted.
The bottles are so beautiful.
The champagne itself, each bottle is riddled individually. Those the etchings on the bottle are handcrafted in copper. Your bottle is worth some money, so is the box on eBay.
Yeah,
so that is an investment.
These are the boxes here,
right.
Yeah.
So we're not going to open that today, though.
But look at... I missed that one just now. Now, it's so beautiful to look at. And this is, of course, your top-of-the-line product. That if you really want to show that you're having a great time and it's a reason for a celebration, you can go ahead and pick up one of these. Now, let's just talk about the difference that we have here. What's the difference between the gold, the pink, and the silver?
Okay. The gold, let's go with the rose. We'll go with the gold.
Okay.
The gold is a brut.
Mm-hmm.
Not very dry, but on the drier side, the rosé is very, very popular.
Okay.
That's medium sweet, and it is the most expensive.
Mm.
And then you have the silver bottle, which is the Blanc de Blanc, which is actually the top of the top. Mm. You want to find out what the prices are, but I won't mention it. But just a little trivia.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When we are drinking champagne, we never think about how many bubbles are in the bottle of champagne.
No.
Can you guess?
Oh, I have no
in
idea.
In the entire
Wait, in a glass.
Are we talking about a good bottle or a good glass or a bad glass?
It doesn't matter. Usually champagne is the best.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Champagne being that...
All right, let's take a wild guess.
Okay.
I'd say 3 million, something crazy.
And how about you, John?
I would, in the bottle you're talking about,
yes.
The entire
bottle. In the bottle or in the bottle?
In one bottle would have somewhere around 3,528.
Good guesses.
And obviously by your faces, we are so off. But that's all right.
Let's think about this.
Mm-hmm.
49 million bubbles. 49 million. That's why... When you're drinking a glass of champagne, savor the bubbles.
Mm.
Don't drink it too fast, because if you're drinking it really fast, the bubbles go right into your head and it gives you a headache.
Instant.
So don't savor your bubbles. Let the bubbles burst in your mouth. Savor it. Sip it. Because in serving the champagne, it's the chill, it's the flute, and it's the pour. three important things.
I would have never had that thought.
So I think we should open a bottle of bubbly now.
So what no problem. Think? So can I hold it?
Because of course, you can open it too.
But right. Well, that one is already open, so you don't get to practice there. We'll get into that.
So you're going to practice with this
Santa Clara, Santa Carolina.
That's from Chile.
Yeah, Chile, 1875. I'm just trying to mention it the way they do it on the TV.
Yeah, but you have to.
Technically,
kind of
it should be on that side. The other way.
Right. Uh-huh. And this is a reasonably priced sparkling wine. Yeah. We call it sparkling wine because it's not made in Champagne.
Okay.
It's just Champagne in France owns the name Champagne. Other than that, it is still sparkling wine. Mm-hmm. Anywhere else in the world,
yes,
it is still sparkling wine, and it's our champagne from Chile.
This is really giving us an opportunity because we're going from the Armand to the Santa Carolina because you have such a wide range of products available for anyone's budget. That's the key thing.
That's right.
All right.
So, because we've got the New Year coming up, you want to wow somebody. You want to actually put them in this. This celebration mood, and I go to the beverage division there at College Mendes, and I want to be as reasonable as possible, but at the same time, I still want to wow you. What would you say to a customer? What would you show them?
Yeah.
Voila.
And that's it.
You got Bel Air Rosé, and this comes from the same Cartier family.
Mm-hmm.
Belongs. It's the youngest daughter of
the
Armand de
Brignac.
Yes. So it's reasonably priced. You can wow your significant other or your close family and friends, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. because what do you toast with? Champagne. Come on, it's sparkling. It's reasonably priced. So,
and I think a lot of people shy away from champagne for many reasons. One, they expect it to be dry. Mm-hmm. One, they expect it to be expensive. Two, they expect it to be dry.
Mm-hmm.
And so they kind of stay in their own comfort zones. So what we want to talk about is some of the different flavors that you can get from the lines that you have offered here, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So let's go with that one. Mm-hmm. When it says demi-sec, it's because it's not dry.
Mm-hmm.
It's in between. This Bel Air Rosé is on the sweeter side. And then, this is the demi-sec mm-hmm. I was talking about.
Yeah.
That's there. And then you have the Mionetto.
Mm-hmm.
The Mionetto is actually the number one selling sparkling wine in the US.
Wow.
And it's caught on here. And it's actually very popular with our Italian friends here in Belize.
Ah.
So you'll find this in many restaurants and even at the Quay. All the restaurants up at the Quay. And then you have, remember we are talking about Mionetto, this is a Prosecco. Mm-hmm. This is the sparkling from Italy.
Okay.
Okay. And then you have another Prosecco. All Proseccos come from Italy.
Okay.
So let's do this. And then you have, if you're afraid of a cork, screw top, keeps the bubbles in there for maybe a day.
Mm-hmm.
And a little bit of trivia, if you have an open bottle of champagne mm-hmm. or sparkling wine and you don't want to use it for the whole day,
mm-hmm.
take a teaspoon, flip it into the cover.
Mm-hmm.
Remember, you can't cork it back. So you put it into the open champagne, store it in your fridge upright. It will maintain the bubbles in there.
With a teaspoon?
With a teaspoon. Because
metal, right?
Metal. Because the curve of the spoon
mm-hmm.
confuses the bubbles. They don't know where to come out because the curve of the spoon actually keeps the bubbles in.
Wow.
A friend of mine taught me that.
There
Thank
we
you,
go.
J-Walk.
Now, the only question I would have is why wouldn't you finish it?
I know, right? I never use a wine stopper.
Mm-hmm.
Or a champagne stopper. What's the use?
Okay, right. So we went through our Proseccos, and what else
so
do
this,
we have
So the sweeter ones, and we have different brands. We have Cupcake.
Uh-huh. And oh, they're very popular.
Right. And then we have the dry ones, which is the Brut.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is the drier one to that, Demi-Sec. And then we have the Grand Rosé, which is also extra Brut. That's why we are going to do the tastings of both.
Okay. What tends to be the favorite? You talked about what the restaurants, what the restaurants are purchasing, but what do people come in requesting the most from their champagne?
Actually, we've done very well with the Prosecco.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
People, you know, that's what we do at the wine division,
mm-hmm.
At the beverage division, at Carlage Menzies. When you come in there, you don't have to be nervous. We want you to learn about wines. We
if
want you
anybody
to know.
If there's anybody who's willing to share knowledge on wines and spirits, it's this lady right
here. Right.
We know that much. Well, but what's great is I love that you ask things like what you're going to be eating, just all of the necessary questions to be able to help people pick the best selection.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, so as not to mix your drinks, you can actually continue with your sparkling wine from the beginning as your aperitif, all the way through your appetizers into your main meal.
Mm-hmm.
You can stick with your sparkling, your Prosecco or your champagne. That is the perfect match.
Well,
I'll
tell you
what. Stick with what you're drinking from the beginning
to
the end, if that's what you want.
Oh, this is of course for you to not go through the whole hangover process.
No, it doesn't matter. You can change. I mean, when you have an aperitif, that's what it means. You have your beginning of your day starts with your evening starts with champagne.
Mm-hmm.
Well, for us, it's beginning of our day. We're champagne.
That's
yeah,
right.
We're doing it with sparkles. So you can start with your sparkles and you'll go into your first course, which is your salads.
Mm-hmm.
Typically, people would go with a white wine.
Mm-hmm.
But stick to your Prosecco. If there's more and your host is willing to serve you more of the good bubbly stuff, stay with that.
All right.
So for newbies heading into the store, let's just go through this one more time. If it says Brut, it's dry. If it says
Demi-sec, it's on the sweeter side.
Okay.
Okay. If you want very sweet,
that's what I was getting at.
Voila! You have the Sutter Home Bubbly Pink Moscato.
Wow.
There is no doubt. Yeah.
This is very sweet, though.
This is sweet. This is sparkling. And
I love that.
Yeah, see?
And it has it's dressed up for New Year's already. So, yeah.
Well,
so if you're going sweet, you're going with
pink Moscato.
Okay. So we did Demi-sec, we did the Moscato.
And you have the extra Brut.
Okay.
All right, which is very dry.
Yes.
The rosé is semi-sweet.
Yes. The Bel Air rosé is actually, it's on the sweeter side, but remember, your sparkling wines must always be at the right temperature.
All right.
Should be between 41 to 48.
Okay.
Or if you want to fast chill it, do it for an hour over rice.
Mm-hmm.
But it has to be that cold. So when it's cold and it's at the right temperature, even the sweeter wines kind of give you that crispy, really nice taste in your mouth that you want to drink one sip and then you take a second sip. And before you know it, your glass has a hole.
But we got to slow down for the bubbles.
Absolutely.
I just have this imagination. You know? And whenever you talk, I'm actually seeing the fireworks, you know, being displayed as we speak,
so
right there on
it.
The beach side. So we're going to pour.
They're going to teach you how to
pour.
You learn how to pour.
You're gonna hold it and learn how to pour.
All right, sure.
Okay. So what you want to do is, on one hand, grip the bottom a bit.
Okay, so here we go.
Yeah, slightly to the side. Almost like you're pouring beer. You know, you don't want too much foam up top.
And in this case, do I have the bottle touch the wine glass or no?
You're a beginner, it doesn't matter.
And I'll take that.
Okay. So you want the least foam possible?
Well, actually, you want some bubbles, but if you want your bottle to last,
mm-hmm.
to give you, from a bottle of champagne or sparkling wine, you should probably get maybe 10, 12 glasses. Now, if you have a lot of bubbles and you have a lot of foam on the top, then you can actually get 15.
Mm.
So it's in the pour. And usually you would leave maybe 2 to 3 fingers off your
from the top.
So when you're drinking it, you don't have the champagne splashing on your nose.
Okay.
So come on,
you actually have to do a lot of things in order to.
Well, you know, after a while, it gets to be second nature. So get a case, and by the time you hit the fourth bottle, you'll have it right.
Mm. All right.
See how White Michael did that? So this is a really good pour.
Yes, that's a good pour.
Because, and look at the amount of bubbles.
So you wanted to leave a bit more space. Yes. Next time you'll know that. Oh, you sipped so that you could get more space. That's cheating.
So.
And we're looking at the bubbles as well.
You're looking at the bubbles. And imagine all these bubbles in your life, all the sparkle in your life.
Ah, that's what's coming in 2017.
Yes, so to a good 2017.
All right, there you go.
And wishing.
You know, we're officially in celebration mode when it's 9 a.m. and we're having champagne.
Definitely. Yep, so cheers. Salute to everyone.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that is lovely. Mm. Wow. Absolutely lovely.
You see the chill?
Yes, I feel a chill.
Because then the thing is, you need to also make sure that it's not that cold that you don't feel it.
Yeah.
Because then it just feels like ice water.
You can't
have it at freezing point. It has to be the right temperature.
And then again, while we've got
what did it taste like?
To me, it has that uva taste to it. I could taste actually the grape. Mm-hmm. That's the first thing that caught me. Mm-hmm. Thereafter, the bubbles came afterwards. So the first thing that got me was the uva, the grape. Mm-hmm. Then the bubbles.
Mm. Are you getting any flavors?
I just love the explosion on my tongue with the bubbles.
Pink guava in there.
It's guava.
Wait, let me one more.
When you look at this, can you imagine that Marilyn Monroe actually took a bath with 350 bottles of champagne? Of course, not at this temperature. But can you imagine? I mean, how great it is.
I just was going to say, that sounds like something to put on the bucket list. There you go. The girl knew what she was doing. So we had the execution of the pour, how much space to leave in the champagne flute itself. You'd mentioned earlier that the flutes are also important. Now, I know a lot of people will probably do the plastic ones if they're having a party. But if you're shopping for your home, what shape should you look for?
The flute is the best.
Yeah.
Actually.
Okay. Yeah. So this is the flute.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. It's standard. It's basic. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know, you can get it at the stores.
Mm-hmm. And this helps in the taste and flavor.
Yeah.
And the experience that you're going to have.
What happens is with this glass, it actually keeps the bubbles. Because if you were doing it from a wine glass, the bubbles would escape. So you're keeping it in the flute, so the bubbles will take time to
make their way up.
And when the bubbles pop up, that's when you get the aromas and the bouquet, and it goes straight up to your nose, and your brain goes like, "Wow, I love that!" You know. And also, sparkling wine, champagne. It's pretty good, and they found that it works well with dementia patients because what it does is the sparkles, the bubbles go up to your brain and it opens up your endorphins.
There
is medical value to that too.
So there's so much
it's preventing dementia too, right? I could use that as an excuse.
Let's take another glass.
Okay, so while we've got all the niceties of the champagne and the wines, there's some I'm sure wives will be flocking to the wine division there.
Oh, wait, who's going?
Wives. No,
sorry.
No, listen to me.
Okay.
I'm sure wives will be flocking to the wine division there at Carl H. Menz's to try and pick something up for her girls because they'll be sitting down. But she also wants to make sure that her husband is properly taken care of. He's not a wine guy. He's not a champagne guy. He's probably a rum guy. And you want to wow him with something strange. Oh, we tired of this, we tired of that, we tired of that. But I'm sure that Carl H. Menz's has definitely got something for the husbands. What does she do?
Voila, there it is. Michael, there you go. We need to keep, you mean your partner, your spouse mm-hmm. quiet while you're having a good time with your friends. That's what you mean, right? So yes. We have,
it's the shut up and go away drink.
Your vodka, which is the Tito's handmade vodka.
Let's move over here.
Yes. Come, Michael. Let's check it out. Take it away, Michael.
Okay, so these are for the spirit people, right?
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I'm glad that you mentioned that,
like
actually,
that
some guys are not into wines, they're not into champagnes. We always try to encourage everyone to drink our wines, you know?
Yes, definitely.
Try something new. But definitely we have different spirits here. One of our top spirits includes Tito's Vodka. It's the number one vodka in America right now. It beats all other vodkas with 95 points.
Wow.
It's right. Gluten-free.
Right.
It's made out of corn.
That's right.
Wow. So it's
so you're getting your vegetable intake when you drink it?
Absolutely. Of course.
Okay, just make
definitely.
Sure.
Definitely. Yeah. See, and not only that label is very simple.
Yeah.
And what Tito Beverage, that's actually his name.
Okay.
Okay.
Decided was he wanted to keep the label simple because it's not what's on the bottle, it's what's in the bottle that's important.
Definitely. We've had a lot of people in Belize actually looking for vodkas, and they're like, oh, I need a pretty bottle, I need something with frost and designs, and but it's at the end of the day, it's what you're drinking inside the bottle that matters, you know.
Well, his simple label seems to have worked out for him.
Definitely.
And it's handcrafted.
And the product is that good. Now what's the difference between this outstanding bottle of vodka and something else that someone can get? Is it the smoothness, or
you could really have a bottle of Tito's and not have to worry about
it's
a hangover
gluten-free?
At all.
Yeah.
Wow. Yeah. It's that smooth, you know? You could drink Tito's straight with just ice, a bit of water if you want, add a wedge of lime, and it has no harsh flavors to it, whereas other vodkas have that.
One thing I'd like to get trashed out is this. In many cases, folks would say, you know what, I want to get a sip before I get back to where I'm going to, but I don't want to have the aroma of alcohol. I don't want to smell like alcohol. So I'll go with vodka. Is that true or false?
Yes, it is true. It is true, but that's why we have to remind everybody, you need to drink responsibly.
That's right.
Yes.
It doesn't matter if they can smell it or if you don't feel that you're high. The idea is don't drink and drive.
Yeah. Okay.
These are for parties where you're settled. It's not to move around afterwards. We don't want to encourage that at all.
That's definitely.
So what else do we have?
I just want to quickly add with the Tito's Vodka. Vodka is one of the famous drinks for Tito's is a Tito's Mule, which consists of a lot of ginger beer, some citrus, some soda, and Tito's Vodka. And it's perfect out of a copper mug, such as this one. And the reason behind that is because copper enhances flavors a lot,
right.
And it refines your drink. So we encourage everyone to, of course.
I thought it comes along with the bottle. That's what I thought.
Wishful thinking.
Michael, they'll have people coming to the store with that.
No. I need
and
a Tito's
Vodka. They're another guys.
I want Tito's with the copper cup. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, apart from our vodka, of course, we have different whiskeys and rums. One of the more popular ones that we have right now is the Pogues whiskey. Pogues is an Irish band, actually.
Great.
And
they
have partnered with West Cork,
okay.
And which is a famous whiskey brand. And they came up with their own whiskey based on a song that they wrote.
Whoa.
It's very popular not only because of the flavors inside. It's a very smooth whiskey. If you're just a starter with whiskey, this is the way to go. Pogues. But also the bottle looks really nice.
Yeah, that's a beautiful
why
bottle.
Not have this on
that's
top
right.
of your shelf, you know?
Yeah.
A whiskey starter. Yeah, because not everybody loves whiskey.
You know what, you'd like that one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
Very creamy.
I like that idea.
This whiskey.
Yeah.
Apart from that, we have for more experienced drinkers, we have the Aran. Also the Macallan Amber and the Three Ships. We're taking you around the world with these. We have stuff from America, from South Africa. Help me here, Miss Mala.
You have Brugal, the rum from Dominica. You have Amarula,
which is also South Africa.
South Africa.
And
you have
our tequila.
Casa Noble Cristal.
Yes.
Fantastic.
Is that the one you're getting excited about? The tequila?
No, I was actually getting excited about this one.
Oh, you're a whiskey drinker.
There are lyrics of the song right behind that. And, you know, if we had thought about it, we would have been able to like YouTube it and just play a little bit. Yeah.
Or I'm pretty sure you could sing it because you've heard it so many times.
Yes, you're very good at it.
How about that?
No.
Wait, Michael's face is like,
it's already raining.
Which is why we have nothing to worry about.
We would be happy to host a whiskey tasting.
Okay, great.
Definitely. So apart from the tequila, which we have in three different varietals,
we have the añejo
and the
we have the reposado.
Yes, okay. But this is the more smoother of the three options.
This would be comparable to maybe a little step higher to your Patron Silver.
Okay,
that would be
And if you're a guy who's you don't want something too strong, you don't want to really go for whiskey, you don't really want vodka because you're tired of drinking vodka, we also have Amarula. This is a liqueur made of the marula fruit from South Africa. Mm-hmm. And it's similar to something of a coffee liqueur.
Yeah. Yes.
But there's
without
no
the caffeine.
Yeah.
So no there's caffeine. No coffee in it.
Yeah.
It has very, very creamy flavors. You can drink it as it is on ice, or you can mix it with different mixers as well.
Yummy. All right. So that's great for someone too who perhaps it's like milky, but it's like creamy, right?
Yeah, it's creamy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So for maybe like a Bailey's lover.
Yeah.
Or,
because the marula fruit is actually made the way you would make wine for 8 months in an oak barrel. And then as they're bottling it, they bottle it. With the cream, so all the textures of the oak and of the barrel that it's been in, you can smell it. You can smell the aromas. So it is a liqueur, but it's made with the whole process of the way they make wine.
Okay. All right. So let's talk. We do have some wine selections here, and I guess these are for the people who say, absolutely do not want to drink champagne. I need a good bottle of wine, right? So what do we have?
Okay, we have almost all of our varietals here today, actually. Let's start off with our white wines.
Okay.
So your white wines are going to be stuff that you want to pair with lighter foods or seafoods, creamier dishes. Your Pinot Grigio is something on the lighter end. It has very crisp citrus flavors to it.
All right.
And that could be paired with something as simple as a ceviche or something like a lobster fritters or a salad, a simple salad.
Okay.
Your Riesling, on the other hand, that's more towards the sweeter end. When a lot of people come to find pairings for different stuff, they often ask, what does this wine taste like? What can I pair it with? Do I need to pair it with something that's similar? Do I need to pair it with something that's different? Your Riesling, because it's on the sweeter end of the whites, you would want to pair it with something opposite. So you want spicy foods that go with that.
Wow.
So your curries.
And which one is
how
that?
How about your Black Reno too?
Yeah.
It goes really well
this
in the Black Reno.
This goes with your Black Reno?
Not you only can, that, you can cook with it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yes.
You can add that into your Black Reno and it gives you such a real crisp, nice flavor to your Black Reno.
It does.
All right.
Apart from that, we have Sauvignon Blanc and the Chardonnay. These are towards the...
This will go well with your ceviche too.
Yeah, definitely, the Sauvignon Blanc. These are more towards your end of the white wines, your drier end
dry.
Of the white
wines.
Not too dry though.
Yeah.
A lot of people get discouraged when they hear dry wine. You know, they think, oh, it's going to be bitter in their mouth or and stuff like that. But definitely not with the Sauvignon Blanc and the Chardonnay. This Chardonnay is from Kendall Jackson. It's one of our newer lines that we just got
that's
in.
That's right.
It's actually their starter varietal for Kendall Jackson. It's the most famous Chardonnay
that's what
for
made
their line.
Kendall Jackson.
Definitely.
Right.
And unlike other Chardonnays where you'll get a lot of oak, a lot of butter flavors from it, this is a very fruity Chardonnay.
Okay.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. So that is your
white wine
selection.
That's
yes.
Right.
Your red wine.
Then.
So let's move on to reds now. We're going to start off with our highlight wine, which is the Ménage à Trois.
It's our flagship.
Yes.
There we go.
And we have this today in three different blends. Your California Red Blend.
Okay.
Your Ménage Silk.
Aha.
And also the Ménage Midnight. So with these three blends, your California Red would be your starter. It's more sweet. It's a blend of about five different.
It's a blend of three. It's Cabernet, Merlot, and Zinfandel.
Okay.
So with your red blend, if you're a new novice wine drinker and you're not sure if you want sweet wine or dry wine, we tell you try the Ménage. Mm-hmm. And if you have the Ménage red blend, you can decide, I think I want it a little drier.
Yes.
I need it a little
sweeter.
So that
one gives you the best of
That's
both worlds.
That's kind of your
introduction.
Your introduction.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And if you want something a little lighter or a little less sweet, we would tell you to take the Silk. Mm-hmm. Because the Silk has a Pinot Noir base.
Okay.
And the Pinot Noir is usually the gentlest of all red wines.
Nice. Mm-hmm.
So even if you're somebody who doesn't know about wine and want to try the Pinot Noir. That's your start, and then you go up the ladder.
Mm. And up the ladder would be?
Up the ladder from your Pinot Noirs, then you would go into your Merlots and stuff like that. And then you have the Midnight, which is Michael's favorite.
Yeah. Really?
For some reason or other, this seems to be something captivating, especially with the name, the Midnight.
Midnight.
I love it.
It's seasonal for one. We bring it once a year.
Yeah.
Michael?
And you know, you were mentioning earlier that guys don't really like wines or they don't really want to go for wines. Your labels have a lot to do with how people purchase. Okay. So as you noticed,
so you
the Midnight.
Mean we can't give the guys cupcake?
We can try to.
They probably give you cupcake. They probably give you cupcake and
they'll see cupcakes on my cupcake.
Yes. Yes.
But your Midnight, as you notice, the labeling is dark. So right from there, you can get that it has darker flavors.
Yeah,
from it.
Plumier.
You'll get a lot of dark red fruits from it. You'll get some chocolate, coffee flavors.
There's a little bit of Malbec. There's a little bit of Petit Sirah. There's a little bit of Petit Verdot. They're really nice little nuances in this wine that you won't find in the others. But of course, if you're a seasoned wine drinker, you'll be able
to pick up this.
To kind of pick it up. But if you're not, don't worry. It's not rocket science. You got to try it.
Yeah.
You know, you boil an egg, then you start to fry your egg, and then you make an omelet. That's as simple as it is.
So the Midnight you only bring in around this time of year, right?
Yeah.
And it's just, I think what Michael's trying to say, but doesn't really want to say, it's like a sexy bottle of wine.
It's called Midnight.
Doesn't it look mysterious?
Yeah.
I mean,
you need some mystery in your life.
So when you bring home a bottle of Midnight, it's just, it's a wow factor,
yeah,
right?
That's right. Yeah. That's right. Yeah.
So, you also have the other, the actual wines, not blends, right?
Yes.
Available in the Ménage line.
Right.
That people can be able to get.
That's right.
So, where are we headed now?
Let's do the La Crema.
Okay.
Which is the top in the Pinot Noir line from Kendall Jackson.
Mm-hmm. Like Ms. Mala was mentioning earlier, you're going to get a lot of lighter red fruit flavors in your Pinot Noir. It's the lighter of the red wines. That doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be a sweet wine, though.
No.
Okay.
No. So from your Pinot Noir, you're going to get a lot of cherries, red plums.
Dark fruit flavors, you know.
As well as some tea flavors.
That's right.
In there as well.
Yeah.
Your Pinot Noir goes well with
everything.
Yeah.
White meats, your red meats, you are safe with Pinot Noir.
Okay.
It's very, very, very food friendly.
All right. Yeah.
Those days when you would say that you have to eat, you have to have white wine with white meats, those are gone.
Yeah.
You can
mix it up the way you like it. Yeah.
All right.
And then lastly, the bottles over there, we have a Malbec.
So you have then after the Pinot Noir,
you have your Merlots.
You have a Concanon there.
You have a Cabernet from
Cupcake. And you have a Malbec there, which is the show. And you have
one more blend, which is the Angoulême Shiraz Viognier.
Okay.
Mm.
Yes.
It's a very unusual blend because Shiraz is not generally paired with Viognier, but this is excellent. And it comes from Australia. And it's screw top, so you don't need.
Yeah. I remember the show, you finally came and said screw tops are okay. People are moving to screw tops.
Absolutely.
Before, people would be very judgy about a screw top bottle.
Right.
And now, lastly, I know you have your Moscatos over here and your Zinfandel.
Moscato.
Right?
Okay. Well, people normally associate Moscato with sweeter wines. Yeah. You know? If you want your sweeter wines, we normally tell people to go with your blush end of the wines. So we've already introduced the bubbly Moscato from Söderholm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Apart from that, we have the Söderholm Red Moscato.
All right.
And the white Zinfandel from Montevina.
Which is not as sweet as the Moscato. Okay. And then the Montevina wineries are actually known for their Zinfandel. Zinfandel is a red grape.
Okay.
Why the blush? Why we have the blush and we call it white? It's just the exposure of the skin of the grapes is kept to a minimal.
Okay.
So that's why you have this beautiful rosé color, and it's the same with all the others. It's just less exposure with the skin, because it's the skin of the grape that gives you the color and the tannins.
Okay. So we went through our full lineup, and here's the thing that we can tell you with certainty. Even if you heard something and you're not quite sure still, go into the store and ask for some help, and they'll be able to guide you as to what the best purchase will be for you. Now, we got to close off because it's absolutely important in learning how to open the bottle, because I love when you tell us that all the theatrics aren't necessarily how it should be done, although you can do it that way if you want, right?
Yep.
Yes.
So let's start. And now we're opening a
Grand Rosé.
This is the extra dry, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, so with opening your champagne, apart from removing the foil off, it normally comes with a screw that you just need to remove.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You need which is really just twisting it off.
Yes, definitely.
And it's always good to have a towel.
Yes. How fast does the cork normally go, Miss Mala?
40 miles per hour.
Yeah.
So it's very good sure that you
use a towel when opening it up. Unless you have a lot of space that you can allow the cork to go.
Yeah.
Yeah. But since we don't have that today, you just want to give, you want to hold it firm, and you just want to give it a
slow twist
while keeping your hand completely over the cork until you hear that pop.
Oh. See? That's
there we go.
Gentle pop. That's it. So now you need to pour. Michael, we have three. You have three. I'll finish mine. you can sip this.
I have.
So you can differentiate.
Okay.
Have a sip of this, and then you have a sip of that.
Okay.
Okay, so then you...
First of all, the color is different.
The color is different, and then you can kind of know the difference in taste right away.
Mm-hmm. Well, if this is extra dry...
You know, it says extra dry, but... It doesn't feel like an extra dry because it's a bubbly. And I always think that champagne or sparkling wine, you don't want it very sweet, because for me, I'd like to drink it all night.
Yeah.
Or all day.
That's what happens with Moscatos. Yeah. Like when you drink Moscatos, it's just too sweet after a while. Yeah.
So
I love, this is the fun part of champagne. Look at it. It looks like a celebration.
It is. It is. Right? It is. It is. Come on.
It's like it keeps on releasing the bubbles and... Yeah. Once you drink it, you start to feel the bubbles in your head.
And it even smells different.
It smells different. If you smell, smells very good.
Okay, so we have the comparison right here.
It's Michael.
Two big difference.
Yeah.
Yeah, and sometimes it's easier when you do this, and then you do...
Oh, we take a sniff in between.
Take it. Yeah, because, you know, even when you go for an eye test, they tell you blink, blink.
Yes.
It's the same thing with this.
With the wine. You go
sniff, or you smell coffee beans, and then you...
Go back to the other one.
Go back, and then you go back.
All right.
And you'll...
So we get to try this one.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Michael.
Okay, so I'll give you guys the opportunity to go ahead and give your 2017 or Happy New Year's plug. Well, and of course, people can be able to purchase Friday and Saturday. Today, Friday, Saturday. Yeah.
All right.
We have a 10% off, and we want to wish everyone a safe, happy, prosperous 2017. And we bid 2016 a fond farewell.
With style.
That's right.
There you go. Cheers, everybody.
Cheers. cheers.
All right, and with that, we are going to take our break. And when we come back, it will be to talk about the New Year's Marathon being hosted by the Orange Walk Rotaract Club. So stay tuned.
Wow, this one is good.